Uncle John Brian. He lived with his mother, a widowed woman aged 94. But she died all of a sudden after eating black pudding from a pig who died 3 weeks before. John, he was sad. She was the only pig that he had. And now lay dead at his feet. Though his poor heart was breaking, he said he'd not waste the bacon from sending his mam love for red meat. A barrel of salt he procured, and the bacon was cured, and he hung it up on a hook over the fire. Such a fine hunk of meat, with no miss before date, or no word on when to expire. The weeks passed by, every morning of fry, they had 2 pork chops each round midday. For the dinner, 'twas bacon, and if I'm not mistaken, 'twas cool beans and rasheen for the tail. But one Friday night, John woke with a fright to hear his man give a strange cough. He rushed to her side. In his arms, sure she died. And her last words, "That pudding was off!" John was distraught, but his very first thought was maybe he'd not let her go. They'd been together for years, shared the joys and the tears. Sure, out or where would he go? Though at 15 he left school, he was nobody's fool. Though not great with figures or words. And from a tutor named Burnley, he learned taxidermy, how to stuff small animals and birds. So armed with this knowledge from St. Shillings College, John set out with great care, and he walked through the night so his man would look right, and he even put a perm on her hair. When his job was complete, the man she looked neat, dressed up in her fine Sunday best, with a hat in her head. If you didn't know she was dead, by God, you'd never have guessed. A week prior to her death, Mam expressed regret to the seaside she'd never gone. She felt an old dip, it might cure her bad hip. "We'll go for your birthday," says John. So to keep her alive, as she'd reached 95, well, that was John's only intention. First things came first, and John feared for the worst when he went downtown for her pension. The postmistress said, "John, how's your mum getting on? I hope she's feeling okay." Says John, "She's all right. She had a very quiet night, and she's not been complaining today. Her birthday rolled by. 'Twas the 6th of July. John parked up the car to the door. He loaded his man and some brown bread and jam, and they both set out for Glendore. They reached the seashore around 4:15. John picked a nice spot on the beach. He had £20 in a jar, cost him 3 for the car. So that left him with 8.50 each. He put out a deck chair, put his man sitting there as though she was having a nap. Poured himself a small paddy, offered men some my waddy, and put the southern star on her lap. But soon John was fast asleep, and the waves rolled in from the deep, and the tide crept close at the shore. It swirled around his man's body, spilled her glass my waddy. But John just continued to snore. He woke with a shock. 'Twas near 9 o'clock. The tide had came in and moved down. The sun was now low. He said, "Mammy, we'll go." So Mammy was already gone. He looked out in the tide. "Oh, Mammy," he cried as he watched her sail over the foam. With a tear in his eye, he waved goodbye and packed up his stuff and went home. Though his man was recovered, his deed was never discovered. They said, "Woman drowned age 94. But John, he knew better, and he'd never forget her, nor the birthday they spent in Glendore.